Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to create this kind of typography. And the nice thing about this is it's easily editable. Let's dive right into this here. So I'm first going to create that background. So we have a rectangle here, and let's just apply some color to that, some bright kind of color like this. And let's just lock that just like this, so we don't need to touch it again. And then we need the text. So let's make a text, and I'm going to make a text frame and type that text like this. Okay, so I have created an area text here, but actually I have typed in those returns, so we can also convert this to point type and then it's easier to handle. Let's make this larger like so. And the next thing is we need this kind of shape, this flowing shape that we have there. So let's just take the pencil tool and then let's just draw this, and it can be larger, that doesn't matter a lot. And let's apply that kind of green color to it like so. And then in order to get this interchanging thing, we can combine the text and that new shape using pathfinders. Now, this is live text and we have the shape, and you know that won't fly with pathfinders, but it will fly because we're not going to just click on those buttons, but press the Alt key and then click on that. And then we get this here. And if I now take the text tool, then you see I can select this and I could change the text, or I could go in here and you see change the typeface. So this is still editable because when you select it, you see up here it's a compound shape. And in a compound shape, you can do all of this. And the nice thing is we can put some more colored things in here. So let's make this in some kind of blue. And if we then take this and send it to the back, then it shines through those holes. So you can edit that and add more shapes. And of course, you can change that shape here as well. And if you want to put some other shapes and add them to it, now comes the interesting part. So let's assume you want some new shape added here. So let's make that green as well. And this should, you know, interact with that typography as well. And now it gets interesting. So let's go into that layer where all the objects are. And what you can now do is with these compound shapes, now on the one hand, you can take the Pathfinder panel and then add to it. So what we could do is press the Alt key again and you see subtract. So this gets subtracted. So in the compound shape, when you take a look into the layers panel, then we have the compound shape here, and then we have another one in there. So we've got the intersecting one inside there, and then added to that, we've got a subtracting one, and you can continue doing so actually, but I'm going to undo it. You can also take this thing and drag it into the existing compound shape. And you see, then it follows the already applied shape mode. Let's undo that again, because I do not want that here. I'm going to delete it. So let's go to the symbols. And let's just drag the symbol out of here. And I want this symbol to be part of that. Now it's a symbol instance, as you see up here. And let's select that compound shape. And let's go into the layers panel. Then you see we've got that compound shape and then that symbol. And then we can go to the pathfinders again and press the Alt key and intersect that as well. And you see it's now black because the top shape was black. So let's undo that and let's change that stacking order and select this and arrange and bring it to the front. And let's now do that again. And there we have that. There's the symbol instance. And now press the Alt key again and intersect. And you see this time it's green. Now there's another thing you can do. So let's go into the layers panel again and into that compound shape. And there's the path. And I'm going to target that. So clicked on the target symbol. So now that path is targeted, but nothing else in those compound shapes. And let's go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and let's zigzag. And you see the zigzag effect only gets applied to that shape, not to the text and not to the symbol. So this is the magic of the compound shapes, and you can have live text in it and you can have live symbols in it. Now, we want to keep all of this live and we still want to have a clipping mask on it. And the easiest way to do so and not ruin anything in here is draw that shape as at the same size as the artboard. Now it's up here, and then you can just click on that layer and then make a mask here. So this is a layer-based clipping mask, and you can still easily select everything that's masked with it. Those are compound shapes, which are really great for editing.